Hi everyone, this is Am, a graphic design how-to, and today we're going to talk about how to make a watercolor brush in Adobe Illustrator CC 2019. And for this tutorial, you'll need to already have your watercolor artwork on a transparent background. And if you don't know how to do that, there's a link in the description and you can just check out another video for that. Okay, let's get started. Okay, so first we'll want to get a watercolor texture with no background. And there's one that I found online and I've put this link in the description. So you can just head over here and use this one or you can use your own. So I'm gonna click free download here and we'll just wait. We have to wait a few seconds and then download PNG. This is going to my downloads. So I'm gonna click on my Illustrator icon and go to File, Place. I'll hit Option Command L, which will take me straight to my downloads, and change my date modified to today and choose this nice PNG. So I'll just place this here. A good rule of thumb is to make this about an inch or so. So I'm gonna get my rulers up by hitting Command R and then I'll control click on them and change this to inches. So the edge of it right here is right where the two is. So I'm gonna make this quite a bit smaller. Just a little bit smaller. So now it's right at about an inch. If I put it over here at zero, yeah, it's a little bit bigger. Okay. So now that you've done that, go to Object, Rasterize, and click Transparent. Your resolution should be at 300, and you'll probably see that this says CMYK, but let's cancel and change our document color mode to RGB. That'll help it be a little brighter, and since this is probably going to be used on the web, we want RGB. Okay, so let's go back up to Object, Rasterize. And now you'll notice it's changed to RGB. Resolution is 300 and we'll choose transparent for the transparent background. And we'll say okay. I'm gonna zoom in on this a little bit. And now let's go to our brushes palette. If this isn't already open, you can go to Window and Brushes right here. I'm going to select all unused and delete those. With this still selected, we're going to click the new brush icon and we'll choose Art Brush. In here, we want it to stretch to fit the stroke length, and the overlap should be the one that is pointy, not this rounded overlap. So the pointy one is the one we want. And the direction should be the right arrow, so this right here. And now we'll say, okay. And this has added this brush to our brushes palette. So if we hit B on our keyboard, which takes us to our brush tool, okay, and now we can start painting with our new brush. Depending on how this is made, you can see some white space at the edges, and that's causing it to have white space at the edge of our brush too. So when you bring that in, maybe we could go into Photoshop and remove some of that extra space around there, and that would change how this looks. In fact, I'm going to do that right now. I'm going to pull that PNG into Photoshop and see if we can get this to be changed. Going to just get it really close to the edges like this with my selection tool. And then I'll hit C, return, which is the crop tool. And we'll save that. And now I'm going to place the new one. Make it pretty small. Maybe a little smaller than what we had. Now I'll create a new brush by just dragging this one into the brushes. We'll choose Art Brush again. Okay, and because of the way I brought this in, it's not allowing me to do an art brush because it's not embedded. So we need to go to Links and then just click the flyout and embed the image. Now we can pull it into our brushes palette, choose Art Brush, say okay. And then we get all the same options. I'm going to stretch to fit stroke length, have a right arrow and make sure this is the pointy one and say okay. And now when we create something with our new brush, you'll see that it starts really close to those edges and we just fixed that in Photoshop. Okay, so these are actually raster images. They're not vectors. If we go to Object Expand Appearance and we get an expanded version of this, there are no points in here. If we hit Command Y, you'll see it's just a picture. If you want this to be made up of editable points, we'll come right up here to Image Trace and choose the dropdown. With these, I usually like to choose 16 colors. We'll say okay. And it might take a while. Okay. And then I'll hit Command E to expand it. And now you can see we have a lot of little tiny paths in there. I'm going to click off over here, and then I'll hit my Y button, which is the magic wand, and I'll click this white in here and just delete it. Now if we draw a rectangle behind it with our M tool, hit D on our keyboard to get a white fill and a black stroke, and then hit Shift X to switch those. Now we have a black box with a white outline. I'm going to hit Shift Command and left bracket to send it to the back. Now you can see how it looks after it's been expanded. If we extend our black background, you can see the difference between the raster edges, which are kind of fuzzy and blurry, and the very hard vector edges that we just created. So it's whatever you want to end up with. Usually I like to have all vectors in my Illustrator files, but this is pretty complex. So in this case, I'd probably stick with this raster one. All right, that's my video for this week. If you liked it, please click on the like button, and I'll see you next week for another graphic design tutorial. Thank you.